Look at the goaltenders, might go at it. Here we go. Brent Johnson with DiPietro. I want to see it. Here we go.
Oh, hit him with a left. He hit him. He's not going to hit him again. But he's going to hold him down and don't let him up.
Well, he hammered him good.
Picked off at center ice by Ballas. He'll just dump it back in around the boards. 49 seconds to go. Now calls it. Shoots for the open goal. It may score. It does! Tri-Cities will win it. It's been done in the NHL. Ron Hextall. Now Olaf Kolzig scores, and listen to the crowd.
Michelle Plas has done it in the minor leagues about 10 years ago. That is the first goaltender to score in the Western Hockey League history.
Wow. And we've seen history closing out this game tonight. You just saw it on Prime Sports Northwest and heard it on the T-Birds Radio Network. Olaf Kolzig not only had a fabulous game at goal tonight, for the Tri-City Americans, he scores a goal. Wow!
Never been done before in the WHL. Only been done a couple times in hockey history.
Olaf Kolzig is one of those goalies who came out of relative obscurity to become one of the top players in the league. Kolzig was born in South Africa to German parents and moved to Canada as a teenager, but never applied for citizenship so that he could represent Germany on an international level. He played in the WHL for the New Westminster and Tri-City Americans, and in 1988-89 finished with the best goals against average of 3.48 and the best save percentage of .905. This led him to being drafted 19th overall in the first round by the Washington Capitals in the 1989 NHL entry draft. Kolzig would play one more year in the WHL and was called up for two games in the NHL to the Capitals. Kolzig definitely left an impression in Tri-City while in his last year there, scoring a goal as a goaltender. In his first two pro seasons, Kolzig would split time between the AHL and ECHL. Kolzig would move up to a minor role in the Washington Capitals organization during the 92-93 season, but then spent most of his time in the AHL for the next several years. It wasn't until 1996-97 that Kolzig was a full-time NHLer, but only playing in 29 games, but posting a goals against average of 2.59 and a .906 save percentage. Those numbers were good enough to prove that he would be a great starting goaltender, and the following season became Washington's starter behind the net, posting great numbers in the process. Kolzig continued to prove that he was a great netminder, and in 99-2000 was voted an NHL All-Star and also won the Vezina Trophy as the league's top goaltender. During the 04-05 lockout, Kolzig went over to the German DEL where he became an All-Star and also winning the league championship in the process. In 05-06, he was awarded the King Clancy Award for his work with autistic children and founding the Carson Kolzig Foundation for Youth Autism in honor of his son. It was a sad day for Caps fans in 2008 when Kolzig signed with the Tampa Bay Lightning, but he would only appear in 8 games that year due to injury. Later in the season, he was traded to the Toronto Maple Leafs but never played due to his injuries. In 2009, Kolzig announced his retirement and was subsequently honored as the ECHL inducted him into their Hall of Fame. Although his playing career ended in 2009, it was his off-ice career and front office career that started back in 2004 that would keep him busy. Along with former Tri-City Americans player Stu Barnes, Kolzig purchased the ownership rights to the Tri-City Americans in 2004 and continues to be part owner of the team today. In addition to this, in 2011, he became the goaltending coach with Washington, and in 2014, transitioned over to be pro development coach with the Capitals. All in all, Kolzig played 14 seasons in the NHL, 13 of which was spent in Washington, amassing 719 games played, with a goals against average of 2.71 and a .906 save percentage. He would represent Germany twice at the World Cup of Hockey, twice at the World Championships, and twice at the Olympic Games. And although he never had a prominent playoff run while as a player, he did manage to secure a Stanley Cup championship with the Capitals in 2018 as part of their coaching staff. Kolzig is definitely proof that you don't have to bring a good rookie up right away. Let him season in the minor leagues for a few years and let him develop naturally. This was a formula that you saw a lot of in the late 80s and early 90s, and it led to great future Hall of Famers, like I'm sure Olof Kolzig will be someday. It's old-time hockey, the way you're supposed to play. You throw a little lumber if a guy gets hit.